Okay. Shall we get this thing rolling? Boop. Hello there. You're here? I am Tom. Let's write some code. Now. Now. Yesterday, we were in the middle of making a level editor. Hello there, Vanus. How are you doing today? So, yeah. As I was saying, we are in the middle of making a level editor, and by in the middle of, I mean we've barely just started and we spent 2 hours going around in circles. But hopefully, we can get a lot more done today now that the basics are all sorted out. So, where were we? We had this bit of code that we did where if the level starts with edit and a colon, then we say, okay, we're going to edit the level and then we just remove the part that says edit at the beginning so that we actually have the proper level code. And then we send the signal that we're editing. And now I think we need a an actual file. So let's see if we can take one of our existing levels and put it into a new format. So let's take this bit first of all. We will create a folder for our maps. I'm just going to call this fact. What we can do is have a folder in here for fun. And think it's in our index file. We have this. So we can create the map. Using the actual level code in there. Now, in our level one, we take this map it out and we let's create a new object. So this will be the actual stored map object. We kind of want at least two different things. Well, we want three different things. One, we want the tile, which is what's represented by this. We will use the same set of tiles on every single level. No matter what it looks like. Let's just turn the light on. It's a bit better. Well, better for the stream, probably not better for me. So yeah, we want the tile. Then we want the animation. And we also want the colour. Although I guess colour might be part of the animation. So, how are we going to do animations? The obvious way would be to have the animations as a file as well. Or maybe we have an animation list. Or animation, I'll call it list for now because map and dictionary don't quite fit. So for the animation list we can have ground, and that has an animation with it, and then we have grass, and that has an animation with it, and then we have entrance is a special one because I think it's going to look the same on every level, and so is exit. And on this level all we have is grass and ground, I believe, because we can have the borders are always going to look the same on every level as well. But let's get rid of the bot, shall we? So, timeout ban. Report, there we go. Twitch doesn't make it easy to find that, does it? Okay, so that's the report. I'm going to block them. And I'm going to ban them. And there's the messages gone. Good. Okay. I think that's just about it back to normal. Okay, so we've got these two animations, And so I'm going to write these out longhand. Actually, I wonder, could I do so if I give each animation a type, and this type will be character, single character, so we'll do it like that, and actually that's the grass one. And then the ground is very similar. Just with a G. We also want a colour. Colour? No, that's the ground colour. So we take this and put it in ground, change the character. I could use free assets for animations and models, but I don't actually have any way to read them into the game at the moment. And also I'm trying to do everything in ASCII art, so I think at the moment it's not, like the animations and models aren't the thing that's holding me up at the moment. Let's just turn down the music very slightly because I can't hear myself at the moment. Okay, that's better. Yeah, the animations and models aren't what's holding me up. What was holding me up was I was finding it really difficult to get more detail onto the map. Which hopefully this will help with. So we've got this map. Background layer will also be added to it, but that can wait a bit. I think maybe I should just try and get this into the game. I'm hoping I can import JSON. So this currently has a tag of 1, but I am going to change the tag to the level name. Actually, I think I'm going to make I think for level we can have an extra parameter. So here I can put in that it is the fun difficulty. Place, so actually I can just use replace, except I'm not sure regular expressions are a thing. Let's look at the text file, because that's where I would have used it. An underscore there. Then in the actual base level, it's used in constructor level. Oh, we want to do this. So base level, level. That's fine. That's fine. That's fine, and that's fine. Okay, so nothing outside accesses it, so I can make it protected. So what I'm going to do is just make sure we only have characters that we want. So if our allowed user input characters includes the tag character, we will add it to the actual tag. Quick and dirty sanitization. So what's next? We want to actually load up the level, I guess. Now, I think maybe we should load up the level in the base level, because that's where the map is passed into. So what shape does level tile detail? This is just... So we've got tile, we've got colour, we've got animation. Okay, so we can construct all of this, I think, from our... from the map we just created. Oh yeah, that's the thing. So let's add in a couple more things. Default animations. The G tile. Now, how am I going to handle this? It should be fairly easy because I just say the default one is can't type today, apparently. Default one is ground. And custom animations. So, 0. There, down to there is where I want it. That is 17 and 10, I think. Yeah, 17 and 10. So if we just do it very hackily and just do column 10, row 17 is grass. And that goes all the way along till column 53. I know, 46 selected, so column 46. There's going to be a lot here. Okay, good to see you, Vanus. Have a good evening. So that's 37, 8, 9, 40. Should we say? Over to column 46. So that's all of the custom grass for that layer. And then the next layer is here. That is 29. So if we just put a blank line there, and all of these become 29, and then can pinch these ones. All of those are grass as well, and then 30. Line 30, character 27 to character 65. So let's do 27 till 30. And then I can pinch the 10 till 20. So actually I only wanted 11 till 20 really. So take those ones, that's 40, that's 50, that's 60. Just need another 5. So all of these become line 30 as well. Comes 31, that becomes 41, Oops. So they're 40. They're 50. And these few become 60. And that should all be all of the grass. Okay, I'm going to take that debug code out because it's annoying me now. In fact, I might have already taken it out and it's just not refreshed properly. Also going to turn off the light because it's giving me a slight headache. One of those days, probably didn't drink enough. So we now have our tiles, our animations, our default animations, and all of that good stuff. So if I just pull this across to there. So in base level, this can go all the way over there. We will create an interface. In fact, we won't create an interface because I don't think that works so well. Does it? Would help if I didn't have it in the middle of a class. Okay, interface is the only one we've got. So that's a bit annoying. I might then put this in its own class so I can have all of it. So tiles is going to be of the type. Oh, it's not level tile detailed, is it? It is level map. So the animation list class is going to have, or animation list item I should say, it's going to have a type which is going to be currently only single character. I know. So what I actually want is single character animation list item. Single character animation, we can call it. So what we kind of need is an abstract class of animation list item, which we had before. Constructor. We will have a private type single character, and I guess that's it. What we will have though is get type, this is getting confusing. What I want to do is use an interface to describe what shape the JSON data will be when it is read in. I don't think I can do that because every time I try and use an interface, it refuses to compile. I'm going to try the interface. Excuse me. Hot day and not enough to drink just makes me yawn so much. Also, probably too much pollen. I am just going to hit intermission for a second, so that I can do something about the hay fever. Okay, should be back. Of course, the code window's gone. There we go. Okay, so we've got the interface level map JSON. Tiles is going to be level map. Single character animation is going to come back. And color is going to be a string. And then we are going to get our animation list item. Oh, this can be the animation list. Except it's going to be a map. So we can just go into here and do animation list is going to be a map string. We can do a type animation list item. And it's just going to be single character animation for now. So we've got that. Don't actually need the commas, I don't think. Default animations is going to be map tile string. Custom animations is going to be a map string. That's going to be it, I think. Except, I don't want maps here. This isn't quite a map, is it? It's a dictionary. I think this is going to be a good point for me to just very quickly search Google to see if assembly script read JSON. Of course, there's a library for it. Tills, is it? Nope. Assembly. JSON.ts. So what does it actually return from the decode? So here's the JSON decode, and it, you pass it a JSON handler. Deserialize returns void. Just realised this has been in the way. Let's get rid of that. Pass key. Last key. Let's see everything that handles last key. Sets the key there. I don't think it reads it, to be honest. So here it sets the last key. Again, it assigns the key, but it doesn't do anything with it. Set string. add value. Okay, so I guess Peak will get set up straight off with an empty object. And then here, where we set string, or where we go down to add value, so this is add value being called. If it gets called with no name, it gets put straight onto this stack. If it's got a name and the last thing on the stack was an object, this gets added to the object. Otherwise it gets pushed onto an array. So let's go back to the decode file. So it doesn't call add value, but it might call, I guess, string, integer, float, push array, pop away, push object. So if I search here for push object, it should be one of the first things it does. There we go, pass object, the first thing it does, sets the key to nothing. Oh, there's where it uses key in the push object. Blind as a bat me sometimes. Okay, so I kind of get what it's doing. Just need to do one final check. In the value class, So it is just a map of a string value, and then is from okay, yeah, very complicated, but I'm guessing what you get at the very end of it is something which basically is a load of maps. Yeah, so you've got to call getString on it for. Yeah, it's a lot more limited than what I was hoping for, but I'm guessing they're working to the limitations they have, which are the same limitations I'm coming up with, that there's no dictionary type, there's just the map type, and there's no record type, which is sort of the equivalent. I think I am a bit stumped. Of course, we don't need to use JSON. We could do a much simpler file format. Because we're not reading arbitrary data, we're going to know exactly what's in it, so we can just. Could do something more like YAML, I guess. Never thought I'd willingly utter that phrase, to be honest. Here's a crazy idea. We could just save it as a TypeScript module. Yeah, I'm liking that idea. That would save a lot of problems. And would also allow for much better hand editing. Need a parser if we're saving it directly into that format, will we? So tiles are level map. We get our animation list item. Our single character animation. Where we get guess a to animation, then where is it? Here. I guess not to animation, it'd be get animation. And we pass in this dot character. So I'm thinking of changing animation so that it's not just one color per block. But I think I might hold off on that for now. this is big changes. I'm trying to get all this straight in my head, how I want everything to work. I guess at the very root of it, I want animation frame to return the colour of each character, but that's, I think the single colour restriction should remain in place because we had enough problems doing one colour per block, let alone one colour per character. So I think here though the colour then should be part of the base object. We have a get type and get color and a get animation which will be abstract here. So we've got our animation list item. Default animations is another map. I wonder if I can do all of these in a constructor object, maybe. Or So I can do those as lap maps. Tiles won't be used outside of this class. I don't think I'm going to convert them straight off. And custom animations is another map string. Get tile detail at base level. Map to tile detail. Level tile detail. So I think we should be aiming to get something like the level tile detail out of this. And if we start off by copying basically all of this code, this is one higher, so two tile detail. That's that, and this just returns tile detail. And it accepts a vector. So we don't need the tile resolver anymore. We won't need to get surrounding tiles, I don't think. Thank you. What is tiles row? It is a string. Yes, of course it is, because we haven't split it yet. Then here we do tile row column. Yeah, we can steal most of this. So we've got boundary side exit. Then tile air, we just break straight away because we want to keep what we've got. Then default. We can do column plus a comma plus the row, that's the position string. If this dot custom animations dot has position string, L-A-B-E-L, I think so. Yeah, looks like it. Animation label is this. Custom animations dot get position string. If animation list dot has animation label, detail.color. Animation equals this dot animation list dot get animation table. Detail.color equals animation dot get color. Actually, we don't even need the type. It doesn't matter to anything else what the type is, it doesn't need to do anything. It just needs the color and the animation. Detail.animation equals animation dot get animation. If some of that's false, then it will stay as its default. I'm not going to do any error checking there. If default animations dot has tile, so now we can break this out into a function. Put that back in there. Animation equals this dot get animation list from label. Slightly long line, but not too bad. If animation does not equal, actually, so what's part of the detail at the moment? Tile, color, animation. Can actually split this out even further. Get detail from animation label. In the tile and the animation label. So we pass in, we get the detail here, passing in the tile, and if detail doesn't equal null, detail equals underscore detail. Then we do something very similar here. There's still lots of duplicate code. Got to open the block. And I think that's all we need to do, really. So we don't need the tile resolver because we've already done boundary side exit. We've already done ground and grass. Then we just push the detail on. So that's the 4. These two need to go across one, I think. Okay, long-winded, but all of that could go into this one that we had, but I don't think that's strictly necessary. Oh yeah, that's the other thing we needed. We needed, I know, because the animation is Yeah, the animation is what it looks like. This can be a private method. Okay, so we now have our new map format, and so what we need to do is this JSON file needs to be renamed as a TS file. So how are we going to do this? We also need to rename this. It's not JSON anymore, it's just like level map. Call it level map detail. Yeah, the bit that's giving me pause now is I can use this file I've got to create an instance of the class, but I don't know how to export that in a way that I can then pull it in a very generic way. And then I'm left basically at the exact same place as I was with the other thing, the way that we're constructing levels from codes now is we just have a whole load of factories that return specific levels. I think I'm going to take a quick bio break, and hopefully when I get back this will be a bit more clear. Okay, I'm back. I think I've got the solution to our problem. If we are auto-generating levels, we can also auto-generate level codes. And we might be able to do it using one of the preprocessors. So, if we look at our issues here, we've got this epic of creating an emulator to run it all. But transforms, they suggested using transforms to do the resource limiting for the emulator, and I reckon we can do transforms for this as well. So all we'll do is we will, in a transform I guess, iterate through all of the maps directory and then auto-generate the code which selects the right level. And then loads it in. So, export function load. Level map detail. Construct a new level map detail with the tiles array. And then get rid of this bit. In the character there, and then the, if I just shift this over here, the color, the same here, we set G to be round, then for all of these then we just need to go and get rid of the ones that messed up on the flank lines. So, now, assume that all of this will be auto-generated. The imports up here might be a bit difficult, but we can definitely work around it if we need to. I guess a default set of imports will be needed. Just import everything. So we've got that. And we've got the code that turns that into a level map detail, which is what we're using at the moment. So this is currently accepting a level tile detail, but we need to change it to accept a level map detail. Just wondering how we do the meta screens, because they don't actually need anything like that. I guess if they don't need anything like that, then we could do a default one for them, can't we? New folder meta. Map.ts. Doesn't have any animations, it doesn't have any default animations, it doesn't have any custom animations. All it has is this. So if we just grab all of this, don't need that bit. This again and paste it in there. And in fact, if we are auto-generating... So, yeah. If we can get rid of a load of this, then it's going to be a lot easier to generate this entire file. Ah, skills. That might have to be part of the map editor as well. Hey, Corinthian. Did it mess up again? Yeah, sorry about that. For some reason, my OBS is absolutely terrible at finding windows. There you go, that should be better. Every time I transition it tries to find the screen again, and if I've changed the title of the window, it can't get it. So, what we are currently doing is, we're trying to lay the groundwork for making a level editor. So, my idea is that I'm going to be able to auto-generate a file like this, where it says, this is the tiles we're going to be using, and here's how to transform those tiles into a visual map that we see. And it should be almost ready. So I need to update the base level so that the constructor takes the level map detail. This and put it up here. That should be some of the only changes I need. So end slate is going to be fine. This needs to change. Clone map. What does clone map do? Um, I was thinking about getting them to import by text file, but WebAssembly in the browser isn't good at reading or writing files. So what I'm hoping to do is add an actual level editor into this, so that you could click on any tile here, and then you set the colour and the animation that it has and some other stuff, and then it will auto-generate a file like this and ask you to save it, and then you put it in the right folder. But there's a lot of work that will go into that. I think the hardest part is the stuff we're doing at the moment, which is just kind of working out what format the map's going to be in and getting it hooked up. That one. Level code entry seems to be okay because it's meta screen. The lemmings were all accounted for. But not all of them made it to the exit. So it knows what happened to every single lemming, and most of them perished. Load from map / meta. That should be okay. Yeah, some days I just get like huge amounts of progress done, and some it's just like little tiny fiddly behind the scenes bit and it doesn't change at all. So load from maps / fun / this one. Okay, and title screen's fine. I think that might be everything we need to do. What file doesn't it like? Default level. Built. Which will level code entry is not an object or function. Hopefully, it's going to like that a lot more. Well, it's got the meta screen at least. That was actually a lot quicker. Let's try that again. Okay, maybe not so quick. It's still taking about 3 seconds, I think. But this should all now be rendering based on the the new files we put in place. Just got a lot of commit messages to go now. Yeah, thanks. I'm quite happy with the progress today. Yeah, is our exit looking okay? It's not good. The exit should be animating, but I'm not sure it is. No, it's not, so I'll have to add that as a bug for next week. Right, so how much actually changed? Quite a bit by the looks of it. I will do the rest of that off screen, and let's see if anyone is around to raid. Not really. Okay, in that case, thank you for watching, Corinthian. Have a good night. And to everyone else, thanks for coming along. You can find my Discord link in my Twitch profile. I tend to stream between 9 PM to 11 PM UK time on Friday, Saturday and Sunday. And whatever else you're doing today, have a good one.